So good morning, students. We can revise last day's portion. Okay. So here, in that last previous class, we discussed about how can we purify water in large quantity, right? How can we purify water in large quantity? How can we do that? How can raise your hand? Those who know the answer, raise your hand. How can we purify water in large quantity? Raise your hand. I can see very few students' hands. Why?
Adidev.
Prajwal. Prajwal, send me the answer. 1 minute. Please wait. Prajwal.
Ma'am, what is the question?
Ma'am.
How can we purify water in large quantity?
By water purifier or by cloth putting on bucket.
Okay, by seeing the municipal supply, can you use the clothes or
chlorine.
Purifiers and all?
Chlorine or alum.
Right. Say chemicals like chlorine and alum. Chemicals like chlorine and alum we can use for purifying water which are in larger quantity. After purifying using chemicals, they are storing the water in municipal tanks, big tanks. You can see there, right? Municipal tanks. From the municipal tanks, the water is supplied to different classes, different houses. That all we learned. And at our home, we don't need a large quantity of water. We need only some quantity of water. So how can we purify that water at our home? How can we purify water at home?
We can purify using the purifier.
Please wait, Varada.
Please tell me. Mama, I said that.
You say it again.
We can use a water purifier to
So many types of water purifiers are available in the market. So we can use that one. Another method. Safest method. Varada. Safest method. Yes, tell me.
You should boil it.
Then? Yeah, which is the safest method is the boiling water. Yeah, I got the answer. Okay. So I will give chance in other time. Okay. So here we can purify water in our home by either by boiling water 10 to 15 minutes. That is the safest method of purification. Otherwise, we can use some purifiers also. So, likewise, we can purify water. We can make it fit for drinking or for using. So, these all things we can do it. So, my question is, see, why we want to purify water? Raise your hand. Sir? Those who know the answer, please raise your hand. Why we need to purify water? Raise it. Leia. Okay, Leia. Why we need to purify water? Tell me, Leia.
We need to purify water to get safe drinking.
Okay, for drinking safely. Is that the answer? Why? Okay, Abel is ready. Abel, why we need to purify water?
Because some germs are in the water.
Okay.
And we don't need it.
Okay.
So
okay. So you are suspecting that. One minute. Adinath, please wait. We are suspecting that some germs, bacteria, which are invisible, that are there in the water. These all germs are harmful substances, right? These are harmful substances. Okay. Any other idea? Any other reason? Why we need to purify it? Varada. Okay, Varada.
If it is municipal water, we should boil. We should purify it because there will be chemicals.
Okay, some chemicals may be mixed with it, right? So you are suspecting that some chemicals are mixed with the water. So that chemicals are harmful substances. These chemicals are harmful substances. Adidev, yes.
Waste from the factories.
Okay, waste from the factories. Some
factories, so we don't want it to be in our body.
Okay, some factories are letting out the waste water into water sources like river or lakes. So that these all contain harmful substances. So that also will mix with the water source. And Adinath, what you want to say?
When we drink the bacteria water.
Okay, that already we discussed it, right?
Ma'am, so when we drink the bacteria water, we have to get sick.
Okay. So you know that, see, from the factories, harmful substances can mix with water. Through the some other reasons also you saw. Somebody have any other reason?
Domestic practice.
Okay, domestic practices. Okay, what do you mean by domestic practices, Prajwal?
By
yes,
cleaning our body ourselves and bathing
the
animals.
Bathing ourselves in the water source. Bathing animals.
And washing clothes.
Washing clothes.
Okay, washing and cleaning clothes, utensils. Throwing
plastic waste.
Okay. So understood. Prajwal, please mute it. Okay. Adidev. Okay. So these all works. Bathing animals, cleaning and washing clothes, and utensils. These all are supposed to do in the home, right? But some people will do these all works near to that water source, like river, lake, and all. So when they do these all, we can call these are domestic practices. These domestic practices, if they do it near to a water source, then there is a chance of mixing harmful substances into the water. Am I right?
Yes,
right
ma'am.
Or wrong?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay.
Yes.
And one more thing is there. Those Ameya, listen. One more thing is there. Those don't have latrines or toilets at their home. What they will do? They will do the peeing and pooping in the open areas, right? They will do the peeping and pooping near the open areas. That means they will urinate. Or they will do number one and number two in the open areas, right? As you, as there is toilets, washrooms are there at your home, you are using that. But some people, if they can't construct a toilet for themselves, they will use open areas for doing it, right? That is called open defecation. Open defecation. That also leads to the mixing of harmful substances in water. Okay, so here I want to share the pictures. Do you want to see the pictures?
Yeah.
Yes, okay. So mute your audio, everybody. Okay, can you see a picture here? Can you see a Sanahin? Sanahin, can you see a picture?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, please, everybody, all others muted. And I want to get it from Sanahin. Sanahin, can you see a picture?
Yes.
Okay, so what is the color of the water that is coming out through the pipe?
Black,
see. Do you feel that, is it fit for drinking?
No.
No way, right? So if that water mixes with the other water, which is clear, can we use that water then?
Another water.
It is dirty water.
Yeah, that also. This water is coming through a factory. the factories are letting out the waste water through huge pipes through the rivers or lakes nearby place. Understood? So when this black water, that waste water, when it mixes with the water sources, the water in the water source also become harmful. Right? That also become harmful substances mixes with that water also. Okay, Arfan, please mute your audio. Next one, you can see one person is spraying something in the ground, on the ground, right?
Ma'am.
Yes, Henry. Okay, Henry, what you want by seeing this picture? Yes,
putting medicine in the
okay, no need to read. What you understood from the picture, that's only I want.
Chemical used to
see that person. Okay, mute your audio. Okay, so thank you for giving that point. See, one person is spraying something on the ground, right? Say he is a farmer. He is spraying some chemicals in his farm. Why he is using these chemicals? Why he is using the chemicals? Okay. Okay. To get more crops and to increase the growth of the plants and also to kill harmful substances, harmful insects.
Because they're harmful.
Okay. So let me explain. I got the answer. Henry, please mute it. Okay, I got the answer. Please let me explain this one. That person is spraying, or we can say farmers will spray chemicals in their farm to increase the plant growth and to kill the harmful insects. So when they spray these old chemicals on their farm, there is a chance of mixing these chemicals in rainwater and can flow into the rivers. Otherwise, these chemicals will absorb into the soil and also it may mix with the underground water. Understood? So this through the underground water, it reach into the nearby water source. So these all can lead to the mixing of harmful substances in water. Okay, next one, we can see so many pictures, right? So Prajwal told it, these all are called domestic practices. Okay, washing clothes, washing utensils or bathing. You can see some wastes are also kept it on the water, right? So these all are called domestic practices. Okay, so have you written that word, new word, domestic practices? Last class you wrote it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, those who have not noted, you can write it now.
Ma'am, last class I'm not there.
Okay, so write down the spelling, domestic practices. Write it and you have to study it. Study this word. Okay, Henry, where you are going? Take a rough book and write fast, domestic practices. Fast. So at that time, Aunt Maria, read the spelling. All others can write it, and Aunt Maria, please read the spelling.
Ma'am, of domestic practices.
Yeah, domestic practices. Spelling. Aunt Maria, read it.
D-O-M-E-S-T-I-C-P-R-A-C-T-I-S-E-S.
Okay, domestic practices, right? Okay. See, let me stop sharing. I can see some 4C student, sorry, which class? 4D students are there in this class?
Tonio Chris.
Okay, Tonio and all 4D, right? So which is the period for you? So, okay, so here we learned about the how the water get harmful substances in it. As the water, we can see the harmful substances that we want to remove from it, right? That is why we are purifying it. Addition of harmful substances in water, that is called water purification. Sorry, water pollution. Here I am going to share the screen. So those who did not write the spelling, write it fast. Domestic practices, write it fast. So that
we
I
are,
can.
We are.
Okay, over. Is it over?
Yes.
Okay. Let me take to the another. Okay, water pollution. Here you are going to learn about the new word, that is water pollution. Write down the new word. Everybody write,
write
down. Yes, water pollution. And Maria? Okay.
Okay.
The addition of harmful substances to the water is called water pollution. Hmm. So, Anne Maria, what do you mean by water pollution? What do you mean by water pollution? See it? You can't say. Leia, Leia, what do you mean by water pollution?
The addition of harmful substances to the water is called water pollution.
Okay, Varada, mute your audio, okay? So, addition of harmful substances in water is called water pollution. I hope everybody had copied the note, this one, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Spelling.
Yes, okay. Ma'am. We yesterday itself.
Okay. Very good. So here we want to discuss. How we can prevent water pollution. Now you know how water is getting polluted. How the harmful substances are getting mixed with the water. You understood? How can we prevent water pollution?
Yes.
Yes, who can say that? You know, now you know how the water is getting polluted. How can we prevent water pollution? Rohit. Yes, Rohit. Yes.
By not throwing plastic in water.
Okay, we should not waste, plastic waste or any household garbages. We should not do that, right? We should not throw the plastic waste or the household garbages in the water. Leia?
Yes. We should stop domestic practices.
Okay, we should stop domestic practices. We should not do that all near a water source. Okay. Another one, Prajwal.
We do not clean the clothes. We don't want to clean the clothes.
Okay, that it is comes under domestic practices. Okay, Varada, next one.
Ma'am.
1 minute. Varada. Arina, please wait. Arina, please wait. I am calling Varada. Please wait. Varada.
Don't do open defecation.
Okay. Oh, don't do open defecation. That is the thing you can do it. Okay. Use the latrines or toilets. Yes, Adinath. What you want?
Do not throw the plastics.
That it is already told. You did not hear that one. Mute your audio. Yes, Adidev.
Stop the waste from the factories going to the water.
We should not let the factory waste to water sources, right? Okay, these, if we do these all things, we can prevent water pollution. We should not let the factory waste mix with the water source. We should not do open defecation. We should prevent domestic practices. We should not use chemicals. We have to control the use of chemicals in our farm. Understood? We have to control the usage of chemicals in the farm. If we do these all things, we can prevent water pollution. So we will get pure water. Okay. So I hope you won't do these all things.
No.
Will you do this all?
No.
I know you are all good students. You won't do it. You will be against water pollution, right? Okay.
Yes.
See, now we want to see what all are the harmful effects of water pollution. If we use that factory water mixed with the water source, right? If we use that harmful substances, what will happen to us?
Man, we'll get disease.
Yeah, we will. There are chances of affecting diseases like cancer, then different types of skin diseases. Understood? So if we use water which is not good, there may be chances of getting harmful, dangerous diseases.
Cholera.
Yeah, waterborne diseases. You in the previous class you learned. Waterborne diseases that spread through
water.
You spread through the water by using water which is not pure. Cholera, oil. Mm-hmm. Are you listening, oil?
Yes.
Can you hear me, oil?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I will ask question. Okay, next question is to you. So please listen. Here we can see that when we use the water which contains harmful substances.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, can you talk a little louder?
Yes, ma'am. Can you talk?
Okay.
Your voice is low.
Okay. So let me. So when we use this impure water, there are chances of getting diseases. Another one. See, plants and animals are living under the water. Right? Can we call them? What we can call them? What is
marine
the name?
Animals.
Aquatic plants and animals.
Yes. Heard?
Yes. Fish aquatic are living in water.
Aquatic plants and animals.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So aquatic plant. See, everybody mute your audio. And Maria, Adidev, please. Varada.
Excuse me, ma'am. I made one underwater.
Okay. Show me. So he made something. I will show it. Use some spotlight video. Okay. So okay. See, aquatic plants and animals. Okay, very good. Aquatic plants and animals. Everybody, please clap. Please give a big clap for Varada. Okay. So these are aquatic plants. Aquatic plants and animals means those plants and animals that lives under the water. So they are using the oxygen which is dissolved in water, right?
Yes.
Aquatic plants and animals use oxygen which is dissolved in water. When these chemicals are mixed with the water, these chemicals can affect these aquatic plants and animals also, right? Okay, the chemicals which are mixed with water can affect these aquatic plants and animals. Not only that, when we use soaps and detergents, chemicals on the farm, these all may increase the growth of plants over the water. You can see it, some rivers or some lakes, you can see some green color plants are growing over the water, floating over the water. Can you see that?
Yes, yes.
So in the when they are saying because of the over usage of soaps, detergents and chemicals, that all can increase the growth of like this harmful plants in the water. They are not useful plants. They are harmful plants. They will float over the water. When they float over the water, can you see the water there?
No.
No. When we see the small plants are floating over, they are in a group. We can't see the water. The same thing will happen. The oxygen will not get into the water. As these plants are covering the full water,
fishes will be die.
As the plants are covering that full water, that water will not get air circulation. If air circulation is not there, the oxygen amount of quantity of oxygen will be less in that water.
I have 7 fishes.
Okay, so that aquatic plants and animals cannot live there. They won't get oxygen. Okay, so Laya and Varada, please mute your audio. As
when we jump in like that, we will die.
Okay, so when we use more and more soap, detergents and chemicals, when these chemicals mix with water, they will increase the growth of harmful plants in water. These plants will float over the water. Due to that, the water under that plants will not get air circulation. The water may not get the oxygen, enough oxygen. So how can that aquatic plants can live without oxygen? It is difficult, right? So these all are the harmful effects of water pollution. There are chances of affecting diseases, dangerous diseases. That can affect the aquatic life of aquatic plants and animals. These all are the harmful effects of the water pollution. Do you know any other harmful effects? Waterborne diseases that can
typhoid.
Waterborne diseases.
And typhoid.
Sorry. Yes, say it loud. Somebody wants to tell it, but saying it very soft. Okay. So I hope you
understand.
Yes, Chris.
We put in water some pollution.
It's not clear. It is not clear.
Okay.
Yes, somebody is calling.
Rohit, I have a doubt.
Okay, who is having doubt? Leia.
Rohit.
All others mute your audio. That is why I can't identify who is talking. Rohit, tell me.
Water plants did not make oxygen like tree, mango tree and all.
No. How the aquatic plants and animals live? They also want to breathe, right? How they can breathe? By they are breathing. We are breathing the oxygen, right? We are taking oxygen from the air. In the same way, aquatic plants and animals also want to live. If they want to live, they need oxygen. So they are under the water. How they will get oxygen? They are taking the oxygen which is dissolved in water. Understood? As we are taking oxygen from the air, in the same way, aquatic animals takes this oxygen which is dissolved in water.
Ma'am, one doubt.
Yes, who is having doubt?
Prajwal.
Yes, Prajwal, tell me.
If we will put in one bowl like the plants like bamboo and we will put it inside two fishes, it can live?
See, it's not clear. Can you tell me some more loud?
Ma'am, when a bowl is there, we will put in it a we will put it water and we will that one plant we will put in it, and when we put fishes, it can leave the fishes.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Some plants are in the aquarium, right? In the some aquarium, yes. We are, yes, using it, right?
My, okay, cousin is doing.
Arfan, say it some more loud.
My cousin is doing.
Okay, your cousin is using
it. Ma'am.
Yes, Ivan.
My cousin's sister is, her home has so much fishes and plants. She's putting so much plants in that aquarium.
I hope everybody understood this.
Ma'am, in my home.
Listen,
in my home,
listen, please. We had already completed this chapter, okay? Water pollution, harmful effects of water pollution, how can we prevent water pollution, that all finished. So this chapter, it is finished, and I will send the new notes today itself. Complete it, and these two chapters are there for the MCQ too. Okay, I will send the portion. So can I wind up today's class? Read the textbook, write and study the new words. Okay, you are not learning properly. Next class onwards, I will ask questions. I will start revision. Spelling test will be there. Okay. Ready for all this. Okay, bye.
Thank you.